Hello and welcome. Where is the best location for a Wi-Fi router? Yes, of course, in the center of the apartment or in the center of the house, so that the Wi-Fi signals have the same distance to all rooms. And where is the best location for a 5G router? Also clear. At the window, or even better, on the roof, so that the router can optimally receive the mobile network out there. And already we have a contradiction. We cannot put a normal 5G to Wi-Fi router on the roof because it is not weatherproof. In addition, we would have the best 5G reception on the roof, but we don't need the router's Wi-Fi on the roof, but in the house, in the apartment, in the rooms. This is what a 5G to Wi-Fi router that is well known in Central Europe looks like. This is the AVM Fritzbox 68505G. The two included cellular antennas can be unscrewed quite easily. After that, you can screw third-party antennas onto the two golden yellow SMA threads. For example, the smaller Poynting XPOL-1-5G antenna. This is an omnidirectional antenna pointing in all directions like a light bulb. Or the larger Poynting XPOL-2-5G antenna. This is a unidirectional antenna with a long, narrow beam like a flashlight. Before we test these external antennas right away, we first disassemble the 5G Fritzbox to understand what the built-in antennas can do and in which directions they radiate. The Fritzbox 68505G brings the internet into the router via the four antennas. Two of the 5G antennas are soldered to the motherboard on two small red boards inside the router. Additionally, two white 5G antennas are screwed to the 5G Fritzbox via SMA threads at the back. The silver Qualcomm X55 modem processes the internet from the mobile network. This is then converted in the black Qualcomm IPQ4019 Wi-Fi processor so that the Fritzbox can transmit it via Wi-Fi to the rest of the apartment, office or house. This is shown by the blue arrows. For this purpose, this 5G to Wi-Fi router still has two tiny Wi-Fi antennas on the back of the motherboard. They are printed directly on the board. They sit roughly in the center underneath the two long blue arrows. Last but not least, you can also get the internet out of the Fritzbox via the four yellow gigabit LAN ports. With this knowledge about the antennas, the question now arises, where is the optimal location for such a 5G to Wi-Fi router? The red arrows, that means the mobile radio waves, come in from outside. This suggests that the 5G router should be installed directly at the window, or even better, on the roof. That's where I have the best cellular coverage, like most people. The blue arrows, that means the Wi-Fi waves inside the house, indicate that the router should be installed centrally, if possible in the middle of the house. In my living room, however, the cellular coverage is much worse than on the roof. The red arrows want to say the cellular internet comes from the balcony into the router. The blue arrows want to say the internet is transmitted via Wi-Fi to the rest of the building. The yellow arrows, that means the LAN cable contacts, indicate that the router should be placed close to the wired IT devices. For example, near the computers, the NAS stations, the switches, or a complete IT rack. In my case, I have miserable cellular coverage in this tech corner, because this small, dark chamber is sandwiched between two massive firewalls of reinforced concrete. Let's now measure how good or how bad the mobile reception is at the different locations and to what extent we can improve the situation with external antennas. Let's start in the technology chamber, which is hostile to wireless. For the first round of measurements, we unscrew the white LTE antennas of the router. The mobile network then only enters the 5G router via the two red antenna plates. With this slightly amputated Fritzbox, we get a reasonable download of 39 megabits, but a very weak upload of 1.2 megabit. The numbers only show the final average of several individual measurements. In the second measurement, we pull the mobile internet into the 5G box via all four antennas. This is what the four red arrows are supposed to symbolize. Of course, a fast computer is always connected to the 5G Fritzbox via a high-quality LAN cable, not via Wi-Fi, so that not a single bit of speed is lost. With all four of its own cellular antennas, the 5G Fritzbox already brings 72 megabits internet to my radio hostile technology corner. But it still has a hard time uploading with 1.47 megabit. On the third try, we connect the LTE 5G round beam antenna called Poynting XPOL-1-5G to the remote 5G router in the concrete chamber via the white antenna cable. This omni antenna brings the internet in over the balcony and through the glass windows from the well-supplied A94 Munich trade fair highway all the way into my living room. So not a particularly good situation for cellular reception, but not a really bad one either. The 5G supplied highway is less than 300 meters away. However, it is no direct line of sight to the Telekom base stations. There are several rows of houses between the yellow highway and my living room in the blue circle above. In this third measurement, the Omni antenna now downloads the internet to the 5G Fritzbox at an average of 84 megabit. The upload improves to 2.91 megabit. In the fourth trial, we now connect the larger directional antenna called Poynting XPOL-2-5G to the remote 5G Fritzbox in the radio hostile concrete chamber with a white antenna cable. This directional antenna also gets the internet through the glass door over the balcony from a Deutsche Telekom cellular tower on the A94 trade fair highway. In this fourth round of measurements, the 5G Fritzbox was able to achieve downloads of 109 megabit and uploads of 7.77 megabit in the anti-radio concrete chamber. So the directional antenna brought a very significant improvement in uploads from 2.9 to 7.7 megabit. It was a bit surprising that the larger directional antenna, XPOL-2-5G, performed so significantly better than the smaller omnidirectional antenna. But maybe we found a good angle when setting up the directional antenna, which allowed the antenna to communicate particularly well with a base station. However, we hope for the best measured values one floor higher, in the top floor. There, we first mounted the smaller Omni antenna at the open roof light. We connected the white antenna cable, which is somewhat hidden by the black pipe, to the two SMA sockets of the 5G Fritzbox. The pipe clamp for mast mounting is also included with the smaller omnidirectional antenna XPOL-1-5G. And if you prefer to drill the small XPOL-1 into the wall or stick it on a window, you will also find suitable accessories on the scope of delivery. Back to our mast mounting on the open skylight. The best 5G mobile radio came from the well-supplied trade fair highway here as well, rather from the left, which is what the red arrow is supposed to symbolize. So we did not align the antenna quite optimally, because with an omnidirectional antenna, it does not really matter how you align it. This is because it has a radiation pattern like a ball, or more precisely, like a donut. The whole tech specs of the antennas have already been covered in detail in the last video. I'll link it above the purple arrow on the right. In the last video, we also explained in detail the characteristics of unidirectional antennas on the left side of the picture and of omnidirectional antennas on the right side of the picture. Back to the practical measurements in the roof. The omnidirectional beam pulled down really nice downloads, averaging 326 megabits into the 5G Fritzbox. But the uploads were also quite reasonable, with 16.9 megabit. For the fixed round of measurements, we also prepared the larger directional antenna, XPOL-2-5G, for mast mounting, unboxing, tech specs, scope of delivery, antenna gain, radiation patterns, and other basics of both antennas, as mentioned, everything already celebrated in detail in the last video. We won't repeat that here. Today we only screw the included mounting material to the directional antenna with a 10 mm wrench. We reconnect the white antenna cable to the two SMA sockets of the 5G Fritzbox in the radio-hostile concrete chamber. Then we turn the large directional antenna to some extent in the direction of the well-supplied trade fair highway. The antenna does not have a direct line of sight to Deutsche Telekom's base stations, but it almost does. In the sixth round of measurements, the directional antenna performed a bit weaker in the download than the smaller omnidirectional antenna before. In upload, however, the directional antenna was almost identical to the omnidirectional antenna with 18.6 megabit. For the seventh and last round of measurements, we turn the directional antenna 90 degrees to the right. Thus, it points in a somewhat wrong and also more densely overground direction. Namely, not to the south, towards the highway, but to the west, where there are still no strong 5G base stations at a short distance. The result of this seventh measurement series was not really bad, with an average of 203 megabit, but it was significantly weaker than the fifth measurement with the omnidirectional antenna, and also somewhat weaker than the sixth measurement with a directional antenna that was better aligned to the south. With extremely good 5G coverage, you don't need external antennas at all. The four small antennas of the 5G Fritzbox alone manage to report up to 1.4 gigabit 5G from the air. However, we cannot get this speed out of the Fritzbox because the Wi-Fi only allows a maximum of 866 megabits and because the LAN ports would also hit the brakes just below 1 gigabit. However, I do not have such good 5G coverage in my apartment. I first had to drive through half of Munich to get such quick screenshots with a direct view of one of the best 5G base stations in Munich. We'll forget about that right away. For the time being, almost no one will get such good values into their own homes via 5G. Let's summarize. When the 5G router was in the hostile concrete chamber, the 5G Fritzbox's own antennas could only perform weakly, especially when transmitting. But not because they are bad antennas, but because they cannot get the best out of the air in the hostile concrete chamber. In this radio hostile concrete corner, we had the first measurement round with only two antennas and the second measurement round with all four Fritz antennas. If the external omnidirectional antenna in the living room was connected to the 5G router in the concrete room, the throughput improved. With the even larger unidirectional antenna in the living room, we were able to improve the upload in particular. We already had 109 to 7.77 megabit. However, it was much more efficient to place the external antennas on the highest skylight in the house. The small omnidirectional antenna XPOL-1-5G from Poynting even achieved the best downloads with 326 megabit. The larger unidirectional antenna XPOL-2-5G was slightly weaker than the smaller omnidirectional antenna XPOL-1-5G. Here we had 290 to 18.69 megabit. with a unidirectional antenna slightly misaligned to the west into denser brush, the download with a large directional antenna dropped almost to 200 megabit. Here we had 203 megabit in download and 19 megabit in upload. So it's not always the biggest and most expensive antenna that has to give the best results. It depends much more on the right use of the right antenna in the right situation. At this point, we can also show the price. The Fritzbox 68505G with a total of 4 mobile antennas was listed at Idealo in November 2022 in the international version from 508 euros. The German version just under 500 euros. We found the round beam antenna XPOL-1-5G at Amazon starting at about 100 euros. And at Idealo at a street price from 94 euros, including tax and shipping for end customers. The larger directional antenna XPOL-2-5G version we found starting at about 150 euros. Dealers also get them cheaper. For example, at ALLNET, there are over 100 products from Poynting around antennas, antenna cables, and antenna connection adapters. The topic antennas is consulting intensive. But at ALLNET, there are people who know antennas very well. If you want to know more about the two very different Poynting antennas, I won't recommend my next video, but the last one, which went into more detail. Last but not least, the data throughput via mobile radio depends on many factors, not only from the antennas. So please do not transfer my measured values one-to-one to other environments. All tests were performed with a 5G SIM card from Deutsche Telekom in the 5G Fritzbox. I cannot say whether the two very different Poynting antennas would have produced different results with other 5G SIM cards, because I have not tested that yet. However, you could also put SIM cards from Telefonica, O2, Vodafone and other providers into the Fritzbox. In addition, the question arises in the end whether the two very different Poynting antennas would have yielded different results on other 5G routers. I cannot say that either, because I could not test that yet. In principle, however, the following routers could also be considered for such tests: Cisco, CradlePoint, Lancom, MikroTik, Netgear, Teltonika, Zyxel, and many more. I haven't tested them with external antennas yet. If you have any wishes, ideas, preferences, or constructive comments, please write it to me directly under this video. Conclusion. At the end of the day, the following remains. Both external Poynting antennas enabled the 5G Fritzbox to transmit and receive significantly better values thanks to the 5-meter cable outside of the 5G hostile concrete chamber. However, with extremely good cellular coverage, such as outdoors, with a direct line of sight to a strong 5G base station, you don't need external 5G antennas at all, as long as the 5G router already comes with a good 5G antenna set of its own. Thanks for watching, and all the best until next time.